I don't want to hear we haven't been consistent with the EPs, huh? I was checking that shit out the other day. Been dropping since October, baby. Let's
talk
go.
About it.
Huh? Let's get it, man. Matt, you let us know when we're fully ready. I see the red light on the roadcaster is good. I'm waiting for you to finish up with the camera. And we can get the shit popping. Let's go. I'm in this today, man. Hyped. Still feeling that Red Bull from last night.
You got some Red Bull for it?
Woo! God damn.
I feel it's good.
Good?
It feels good, yeah.
I never trust those like those pieces like the frozen ones. I don't trust them.
Some of them.
Apparently Delicio is done. I seen that.
It's just been done.
I seen that.
Continued?
Done.
Yeah, it wasn't delicious. Yeah. So, yeah,
this wasn't, not, wasn't part, delicioso?
All right, we're Gucci.
Let's run it.
Let's get it, man. Let's get into another podcast, man.
All right, you press record or what?
Yeah, he's good.
Yeah, we're good.
He's ready to go.
We're all good.
We're recording.
Yes, we are.
He's ready to go, man. DV, you doing an intro? You're good now? You're back? You seem like you're...
Let's go!
Yeah, you're back.
Okay, the good. Rich!
I love my job.
We here! Guys are talking about consistency. Talk about it!
I bet, baby! Let's get it! October! We told y'all, we back!
November!
We
pod.
Stay dropping!
December! We parted! Huh? Man's around vacation too.
Huh?
But we still delivered the episodes. Wow, vacation was happening, huh? January, kick down the door. We kick down the door in January. Like, yo, should we drop any episodes or not? Let's drop some shit.
And the funny thing is, too, in the background, we have a project. That's what I love to say, baby.
Let's
we
go.
Have a project. Let's go. It. Y'all gonna like it. I want to give a big shout out to the people who have been linking us and telling us to keep going with the podcast, man.
Yes.
Huh? I told you, we ain't stopping, fam.
It's crazy because I don't hear Matt hear no gunshots.
That's the crazy thing, too. He yamming. He yamming looking
crazy.
At us. Don't be doing that in the mic. But let's get it, man. Shout out to all y'all. Welcome back to another episode. DV with the intro of this bitch. Let's go.
Yeah, let's go. I'm your host, DV, goddammit. I'm alongside Cards and Stu. Matt is on the back on the keys.
Boom, boom.
Kes will be here just now.
Yes, sir.
What are you talking about?
Let's get it, man.
Do I
love what you did last time? But I said Kes to connect, and that's the name of his business back in the day.
Yeah.
His first business.
Hell
I was
first
how
one.
Did you remember that?
IT business.
Yeah, I'm like, how did you remember that?
Let's get it. Shout out to you if you're listening to this on your way to work.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to you if you're listening to this after work, at home, cleaning. What else people be doing?
Walking. You already know
whatever
it is,
type of
whatever
exercise
you're doing right
you're
now.
Doing. And thank you for listening to us and choosing this specific time to listen to us.
Let's get it,
it's
man.
Like we knew you were going to...
Let's get it, man.
Anyways, I'm on some fourth wall shit. Cods, what's happening? How are you, fam?
I'm wonderful, man. Can't complain, dog. Let's get it, bro. We're here for it.
Two out of the three of us had a long night.
Fucking hell. We can get home until 3:30?
Yes.
Yeah, I slept like a baby.
Thanks, Matt.
And, you know what?
You were a dead man this earlier. Yeah. I thought it was going to be a bad one.
I had some water.
Yeah.
I took a shit.
Great.
That helped. Yep. And yeah, we're here now.
We're back for it, man. Let's get it, man.
The most interesting part about last night wasn't at the bar, though.
It was at Filthy's.
It was at Filthy's. So Filthy
Filthy
Phil's,
what?
Filthy Phil's?
Filthy, yeah.
Something like that.
And where is that for people that don't know?
Lakeshore here, Ontario.
PC.
PC, baby.
Poor credit. Mississauga.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, shout out to Filthy Phil's, man.
Damn, they hosted us nicely.
They're great.
We're doing the most.
Yeah. We brought them some business, though. And I knew that once I traveled with a group to go get Filthy's, I got to go first. So I ran.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I was looking for DV and my family. Where'd this guy go? Open door, this guy had his dollars out in his hand. Yup. Can I get a medium poutine? I'm like, fam, you nasty ass.
Hold on. Yep, I got the dollar's
reaction every single time.
Let's get it.
Stupid.
So yes, I ordered a poutine, and Cordell said that was nasty. Cordell talks really quick, so you got to catch him when he's talking. What do you mean by nasty, Cards?
Okay, let me break something down for you. I don't like poutine.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like melted cheese like that unless it's a pizza. I'm not a big fan of it. And when it comes to poutine with the gravy, I'm not a fan of gravy like that. That's not it for me. That's not it.
Okay.
Not it.
So
I can have a 1-2 bite, and then I'm cool, and I can't eat a whole one to myself.
Okay. So it's interesting that you said this, because the first time we went to Filthy's What did you order at this poutine spot? The first time we went to Filthy's.
I got poutine. That was my first time ever having a poutine.
No, the first time he went to Filthy's, you got fries.
And I'm like, it wasn't called Filthy's then.
It was.
It was called Filthy's then?
Guarantee.
What was it called before?
No, it wasn't the smoked poutine spot.
Okay. It was.
And I was just like, yo, this guy's fried.
I just got fries.
And then he was just like, these fries are trash.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yo, you're doing it wrong.
I didn't like it.
So then you got
a poutine.
Poutine. And you're like, yo, this. But you preferred the fries over the.
Oh, I preferred at that time, I preferred the poutine over the fries.
So now, let's update it to last night. He goes in and he asks, yo, can I get a poutine without the gravy and the cheese? Matt, you being our Canadian expert and local.
Fucking cares the national dish of Canada.
Local white guy, yes.
Cares the fucking national dish of Canada.
Uh-huh. Matt, can you have a poutine without cheese and gravy? Is that a thing?
Can it not be different sauces? No. Can I just not have it with a different sauce? I don't like gravy.
It's not poutine unless it has gravy and cheese curds.
That's tripping. That's trippiness. I don't care.
I'm with Cordell on this though. I've never been totally crazy about poutine.
Oh wow. Shit! Wow.
I've never been totally crazy about poutine. It's never been my.
I'm surprised about that.
I don't get excited at the end of the night when the girls are like let's go to that place. What's it called?
Time out. Sorry, Matt. Did you hear what DB just said?
What?
I said, yo, that's a rum belly. He's like, that's the best part. Why do I want to be? That's the funny thing. These two, Johnny and DV were both on this one at the same time at different wash. Obviously, different washrooms, but and my house was packed up, bro.
You guys heard of synchronized swimmers, right? synchronized shitters.
My cousin was a synchronized swimmer.
Sorry.
US team.
I'm not rolling with poutine. I'm not rolling with it. But what I do ask you guys, what is like one of your favorite dishes? Like, if there's one thing you can order from a restaurant and they have it, what would that be?
Are you talking about after the club or just in general? Because after the club is interesting.
Tacos.
After the club.
After the
tacos.
Club? After
tacos.
Club?
Tacos.
I'm still rolling poutine. Poutine is now ingrained in just my system. Something with fries.
I don't know what it is, but you need something like greasy after you go clubbing and drinking all that shit.
Yeah.
That's why McDonald's lines be insanely long. Facts. And that's why they're 24 hours from. They're making the killing during the night.
No, McDonald's breakfast. McDonald's breakfast cure.
That's another green run belly.
You're not that guy, pal. Trust me. You're not that guy.
McDonald's that guy. Versus Tim Hortons breakfast. I could have that conversation all day.
Timmy's
I'll take Timmy's.
Do you see how Timmy's coming out with the bowls now? They have the rice and the carrots and all the bowls now. Huh? The Chipotle bowl. What?
Matt, have you tried the Timmy's pizza before or no?
No.
Timmy's has pizza? Timmy's does not have pizza. No, he's talking shit. Bullshit.
You didn't know that?
Timmy's has pizza?
Yeah, it's like small.
We're talking about the right place, right? Tim Hortons.
Tim Hortons.
Where I get donuts and coffee.
Tim Hortons,
has
yo.
Pizza.
Yeah. It's owned by a fucking Brazilian fucking firm now.
Yeah.
Tim Hortons is not Canadian.
It's like Subway now. Firm. Subway has the same like bowls and shit.
Yeah, but the difference between Tim Hortons and Subway is we want to go to Tim Hortons. That's the difference.
Honestly, Subway's shit. Subway's one of those things, like, if it's there... And, like, there's nothing else, then bet. I'll get a 6-inch. Pause. But, yeah, I know you thought I was going to slip up on that, bitch. Yeah, you thought.
Yeah, man, like, who's going to say it? Okay.
But, yeah, that's if it's just there.
True.
That's if it's just there still. But
so,
wait,
so what's your go-to after the club, then?
I'm with Matt. Tacos.
Tacos. Where are you guys really finding?
Either tacos, my second choice is a burger.
Yeah, that like I was gonna say, like where do you really like find tacos burger. Just accessibly like that?
If you're on King Street, downtown Toronto, that food truck that's by Early Mercy, the best burgers.
Have you ever tried a Doritos taco? Tried it last night for the first time, man.
That was fire.
That was lit.
And I'm picky about food.
Yeah, that's lit.
I haven't tried it yet.
Matt.
Yeah, I gotta give that some air horns. That shit is fire.
The dill pickle one, or whatever the other one was? Nah.
Fuck the pickle one.
No. Can't roll.
Definitely like some sweet chili heat. Kind of.
Sweet chili heat are the best Doritos. No cap.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. Goddamn. All right. Well, shit.
Speaking of food, they were tossing eggs at my man's.
Good riddance.
Yeah. Jeez.
I don't like the fact that
I love how he's literally just in the office, like reading the paper. It's literally like, don't you got a job to do? No wonder that you're getting fucking egged. Like,
man, who's he? For our listeners that don't know,
he's a they.
He's late. Anyways, John Tory.
I don't know if I should beep that or not.
Nah, it's okay.
Okay, we're good.
You can leave that in. Pause. Okay. No. So for John Tory, John Tory is he's out of here now, yo. He's pretty much out of here. A lot of people are showing a lot of their feelings towards him, and they expressed it by throwing eggs at his office.
And the fact that security, like, there's not like, more security around and to rectify that, like, to get that guy. Like, I didn't hear the man got arrested or anything. You guys hear anything happening?
Oh, no, because it was security throwing the eggs.
Was it actually?
No,
I was about to say. Yo, Canada, I tell you. Canada. We're going downhill. That's all I can really say.
So, honestly, this is why.
Actually, security.
No. But I'm sure they're just like, here, 7-Eleven, go get some eggs for me. No, but honestly, well, we had a conversation about politics recently, right? On one of the pods. And
yes, we did.
I think that you guys are totally right on it, too. Like,
to what part?
Like, just knowing, like, what the politician wants to do.
Yeah.
I think before you vote.
Yeah, it is important. But I think I always say, mm-hmm. Doesn't matter who you vote for, you're still getting slapped in the head with some nonsense, some bacchanal.
Some foolishness, yeah.
Yeah, there's some foolishness. Everything that they're saying right now sounds good, but what are they really going to do when they actually get to work? What are they really going to do in the next 3-4 months?
Nothing.
Yeah, some goofy ass stuff. Oh, we got to raise taxes again. Oh, groceries are going up. Oh, gas this. Oh, this happening. What happened to other stuff you're talking about, how we're going to have free? Didn't we have a conversation about how schooling's going to be free, like going to college and stuff's going to be free for people? Why are we not working on that? Why are we working on so many other projects that don't mean as much
to
Canada, to us? That makes no sense to me.
And that's why
it hurts my head.
That's why
that's
why Hazel's like a real one.
Facts.
Like, Hazel built this city pretty much.
She built that city and she'll really put her foot into it.
She built this city.
She'll put her foot into it for sure, 100%. Yeah. Rest in peace again.
Rest in peace, Hazel, yo.
Holy.
Queen. Okay. So, in other news. We got, I'm going to let you guys pick. We got Vince McMahon. I got Blueface versus Chris Brown. And
Blueface
versus
Chris Brown, because I didn't hear about what happened, but I heard they're calling each other out. But
okay, so pretty much.
I saw Chris Brown bring a fan up on stage. You see that?
Matt.
We'll get to that.
It's almost there. So with Chris Brown versus Blueface, this is only a thing just because Chris Brown decided to say, yo, enough is enough. Every time when there's some type of abuse happening between relationships, it gets put under the rug. And for me, speaking for Chris Brown, but not speaking for him at the same time, for me, you guys are pretty much disrespecting me because I still had to hold it down because of what I did X amount of years ago.
Yeah.
15 years ago, right? So
They're
bringing that up, and then Blueface pretty much came in to say, yo, mind your own business. Because Chris kind of did post the people that have been in these abusive type of relationships, and everybody's, like, pushing it to the side and then whatever. But then Chris got the most smoke.
Most heat.
So what are your thoughts on that, yo?
I agree with Chris.
Yeah, I'm rolling with Chris.
I agree with Chris, man.
And I'm biased, though, in this. But Cordell's not biased.
It's just like, yo, like, if shit happens and I get called out for it, and it got blown up, and for sure, what Chris did wasn't the most smartest decision, obviously, but the fact that it continues to happen and, like, it gets, like you said, under the rug, it's like, yo, how come they're not getting shown Wagwan about this shit? This is a big shit. It's serious.
Yeah.
It's not a little light thing. This is serious.
Yo, no, we're watching it in live.
It's serious, yeah. So I agree with Chris. I'm rolling with it.
I'm rolling with Chris. And also,
sorry, Blueface.
I'm also
X-Trapper.
I'm also going to say that the way Chris went about it maybe was wrong because he posted all these other people, right? But I think he was just fed up because, yo, you guys keep playing with my name.
Yeah.
And we're so past that.
Anytime anything were to happen in an abusive relationship, it's always, she got Chris Brown. Oh, it's like, fam.
Yeah, even with Tory.
We could dead that,
We did the Tory thing.
Exactly,
yeah.
We could dead that. Yeah. Yeah, we could dead now. Like, it's been years.
And also,
it's not just him who's ever done that. There's multiple. For example, that's what he's trying to show.
Yeah, and
we looked at it just as serious as Chris.
Hell yeah! I feel like with Chris's thing, a lot of people just keep bringing it up just because of the level of superstardom, and I'm just gonna leave it at that.
You're right.
Respects to Chris because we love you and we fuck with you here. And yeah, it's definitely not fair for him to still be going through that. Like, yes, he went through that. He got to learn it. He was young in. He was like 19, 20. Still a kid.
Yeah, fam.
Still a
young
kid.
In,
so he's learning, right? And
Image having all that money, all that fame, all that shit, shit you have, and then, yeah. So
I say the same with Justin Bieber. Even though he came out with Mr. the racist remarks younger, youngin. You know no better.
Yeah.
You know
no
better. So.
You know no better. It's true.
Yeah.
It's
true. And also, last point about this. Him and Rihanna, like Chris and Rihanna, are both past it.
Way past it.
Like, they support each other
now.
Yeah,
completely past it.
Yeah.
It happened. Like, we talked about it. We sat down and dealt with it. And we move on with it.
For example, Rihanna was just cooling and she was playing a Chris Brown featuring her song. Forgot the name of the song. Together, Get Together, some shit like that. Mm. But Rihanna was playing in the background. She's vibing. Mm-hmm. Her fans went off on her because they're like, yo, why are you playing Chris? But it's like,
that's crazy to me. We're past that.
And I could do whatever I want because you guys, no offense, but you guys look up to me.
So, yeah.
I'm the person. I'm setting the standard here. You guys have to follow. So
it's very true.
That's just how I feel on that.
I agree. That's the problem of being like a super, like, the fame is crazy. And that's why we always say, like, yo, I don't want the fame.
My favorite Migos affiliate bar ever. I'd rather be rich than famous. What are you talking about? I'd rather be rich than famous. The fuck?
Fuck, bro,
all that shit.
It's cool and all. Like, it's cool getting, like, respect. Then there comes the haters. And then it comes the people that don't like. And it comes all that shit. And it gets a little bit dangerous. So, I'd rather dolls, fam. Mm-hmm. I'd rather stay quiet, under the rug, cooling with my bread. Nobody knows nothing.
Speaking of bread, Vince. Our man, Vince McMahon.
What happened with him?
So.
How come I heard nothing? I feel like I've lost this podcast right now.
We'll.
Wait, everyone's explained everything to me.
Yeah, no, we'll get it all out. So
I feel like I'm a real car guy. Like, I don't care about anything else but, like,
yeah,
my
we only,
shit.
Yeah.
I realize that.
It's good, though.
You guys know everything else,
good,
and I'm like,
it's good. It keeps you focused, though.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I feel vision. I feel bad sometimes because, like, I'm like, wow, what? I've been, like, under a rock. I didn't know about that.
But that's why that's
why it's cool coming to the podcast.
You cool it and you focus on making your money.
Facts.
But this is what I told you in the beginning when we first started this. Yo, don't come in acting like you know shit.
There's no point.
There's no point because there's people listening that really don't know. So if you ask those questions,
then people will know. Yeah.
My man's. Come on now. My man's in them. All right. So with Vince now, let me fill you in. Pause. I was waiting for someone. It's okay.
No, I was
waiting
for you to say pause.
Oh, okay. So yeah. So Vince McMahon is selling the WWE. We'll play two games. Guess.
Is this a real thing?
Yeah.
Or is this like
he's
a little...
looking for? He's trying to sell it. Guess how much he is selling it for?
$5 billion or something.
Okay, that's your one guess. Not mad at that.
$5 billion. I'm gonna go at least 10.
Woo!
At least 10, bro. You know what?
It's streaming. Streaming. That's
you know old.
You sell the WWE.
WWE. There's two rosters.
That's Friday Night SmackDown. That's Monday
Friday
Night Raw.
Mm-hmm.
And that's every other affiliate with
TLC.
That.
Is it TLC?
I don't know.
Yeah, every other wrestling fucking thing that he owns. Yeah.
I mean, $10 billion.
So he's selling it for, Cordell's really close, $9 billion.
He wants to be a billionaire.
What's the guy who owns Amazon? What's his name again?
Bezos.
Yeah, hey, here.
Bezos
he's about to turn that shit up.
Bezos
can
pay for
it. He's about to pick that shit up just now. Oh, that's light.
Bezos is about to have robots fighting in the ring. But to have like some Terminator matches
Amazon,
and shit in the ring.
Amazon she could put up. He's buying that. He's buying that.
And
I'll send it to him.
This is only
like, yo, Bezos. I sent you the deal, so cut me in. Give me 1%.
So it's just interesting just because
that's crazy.
The WWE and maybe I guess the WWE bought WWF, mm-hmm. right? But it all started in 1953. So some people may be watching this and be like, yo, how come he's selling it for so much?
There's
so much catalog.
There's history.
Yeah.
Catalog.
There's so much catalog that
you're
trying to just get rid of pretty much. And you could keep repurposing that
It's content, bro. What are you talking about?
It's content, yeah.
It's so much content.
Yeah.
Like I said, Mr. Amazon, this is an easy one for you.
So let me also add
in. Mr. Tesla, man, you're...
I wouldn't be doing my job as a podcaster without saying exactly why he's selling it. Now, there's been lots of allegations and stuff of just Vince McMahon just being a shitty person, from sexual assault.
Oh,
maybe
shit.
Maybe a little 1-2 rape. Matt.
Oh, my God.
Matt, you gotta.
What are you doing back there, fam?
I got a sinus infection.
I know you're white, but don't make sure there's no white stuff back there.
I promise there won't be any white stuff.
I'm joking.
But yeah, there's just been lots of stuff on Vince, and that's why he is selling the WWE. Now, my second question is, do you guys think that people should be allowed to benefit off of their wrongdoings like that?
Fuck no.
Because
fuck no. You should not.
Is that even a loss for him if he'll go through trial, right? Whatever. But
there is the chance of him actually going to jail and getting caught with all the allegations.
It's a lot.
Exactly. There's a high chance, but at the same time, fam, he has millions and millions and millions. And I feel like when you have that much money behind you, billions.
Yeah.
Once you have that much money behind you, I feel like you're sometimes untouchable. You really are. It's crazy to say, do a crime, for example, or I do a crime, compared to when someone who has billions of dollars, fam. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Man, I hope you're listening, because this is a great segue into what you want to talk about. But yeah.
You get caught with a gun. I get caught with a gun. You get caught with a gun. Oh, I can't shout for 10 years. But if you get caught with guns, don't do it again.
What was the actor that shot that lady? Rest in peace to her. Can we
pause and actually find that? Because I actually want to talk about that. Because that's kind of crazy.
Alex Baldwin.
Yes.
Alex Baldwin.
On the set of Rust.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. That was a crazy situation.
You got charged with manslaughter, right? Yeah.
That's so unfortunate. I don't know the background story of what happened. I just know the gun wasn't supposed to be loaded.
Yeah, it wasn't supposed to be loaded.
It was not supposed to be loaded.
So he loaded the gun?
No, but I think it's a production company, and I think he is like, he runs a production company. I don't know. Like, it's one of those
it's such a tough one. I feel that's so, like, obviously, I feel like he didn't, obviously, he didn't mean to do that, but like, it's just such a shitty situation. And obviously, rest in peace.
Yeah.
I don't know the person's name, but rest in peace to them for sure. That's so sad. Mm-hmm. That's so, so sad. It's so unfortunate.
Okay, so speaking of billionaires getting away with shit, Matt, take it away.
What are we saying?
Speaking of billionaires getting away with shit, Matthew, the list you wanted to talk about.
Oh yeah, Mr. So we had the new list.
It's like he's the one who turned up last night.
Matt is balled up. Like
we had the list finally get released. The court documents get released of everybody who's attended Mr. Jeffrey Epstein's island.
Do you think this list is legit though? This is the same list that I saw like a few years ago, and it looked cap. It's the same list. It's the exact same list. I saw Jay-Z. I saw Beyonce. I'm not rolling with this list. I'm sorry.
So what's this list? What's happening? What's popping?
Yeah. So
talk to me.
So there's a lot of pedophiles. Put it this way.
And explain the Jeffrey Epstein shit.
Oh, fuck.
Epstein's Islands is where all these people would go. There'd be children on these things, and they'd do, like, ceremonies and shit. It's like the island's pretty much a pedo island. So anybody that's on that list, on his planes, going to this island is pretty much doing pedophile shit.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Jay-Z's on this list?
Yep.
Matt, you want to read out some of the names that you said you wanted to highlight, I guess?
Justin Trudeau's on the list with his wife, by the way. Obviously, Clinton's down on the list.
I believe that one. Sorry. I'm going to, Matt, go through some of the list, and we'll say which one we believe and we don't believe.
All right. So,
we're able to locate list here. Again, I'm not 100% on this list. Well, I'm not on this list, but I'm not rolling with this list.
I hope not.
But the names are
canceled so quick.
Yeah, no. But this, some of the names are intriguing, so I'll go through a little 1-2.
Are we gonna say cap or no cap, or believe it or not believe it?
Yeah, all of us.
Bet.
Okay, Akon.
Believe it.
Believe it.
I believe it. Alec Baldwin. Believe.
Yep.
Believe. Anderson Cooper. Definitely believe.
Oh, definitely.
Don't ask me why.
definitely.
He's on CNN. Of course I believe that.
What?
Obama.
No.
I'm not rolling.
Nope.
Yep.
No.
Ben Affleck. I'm not rolling with that either. Not Ben. No. Not Ben.
I don't think so.
Bernie Sanders.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm not rolling with that one either. Beyonce. No.
No.
Yes.
No. No.
Yo, you conspiracy guys kill me. Chris Tucker. No.
That's hard.
No.
Dog, come on.
No, because everyone tells me I look like Chris Tucker. So I'm wrong. No.
Ellen. Ellen? DeGeneres?
Yep.
Yes.
Yep.
I believe that one.
I think so.
George Clooney?
Yes.
Yeah, I believe that one too. Gwen Stefani? No.
Don't know who the fuck that is.
Gwen Stefani's the singer.
She's the
singer.
They know how the Batgirl.
Oh!
No. No, I don't think she was there.
Love the singing. God damn. I'm just gonna go with, I'm in the middle. Don't
okay,
know.
Jim Carrey.
Yes, unfortunately.
I'm gonna say no for that one. Cause I've seen him just be too stand up in those types of situations where women are super uncomfortable and he steps in to, you know?
Yeah, no.
So I'm gonna say no to that one. No, no. Joe Biden. Yeah, he's
absolutely
old enough.
Absolutely.
He's old enough.
He's a kid sniffer. Have you seen his videos?
What'd you say?
He's a kid sniffer. Have you seen the videos? Yo, Cordell, just look up the video, and when you edit it.
Have I been under a rock?
So
he's a kid sniffer? What is that?
Explain it for our listeners, please.
Is that the whole list, or are we still continuing after that?
Still going.
So okay, there's a lot of videos of Joe Biden, like, going up to a kid and, like, putting his arm around and, like, going in and, like, sniffing the fucking kid. Like.
Yeah.
Yeah, like it's fucked. Like he's a fucking creep.
I love pokes and all, but you don't see me fucking go up the shirt and fucking smelling their pokes. Like, what kind of foolery is this? You're sniffing kids?
No, he'll go in like the neck and they'll go like,
oh no.
Shit like that, yeah.
Okay. To continue
he's a big pedophile and he's in charge of the US right now.
To well, continue not with
really,
this list.
Puppet, but,
so. Okay, we just had Trump in there. John Travolta.
Yeah.
Not John really. Travolta? No, I'm not rolling with that one. Justin Trudeau, Matt?
Absolutely.
Yes.
I might be wrong with that one too. Yeah. Who else
he'd
we got?
He really loves the alphabet people. So I would.
Lady Gaga.
Edit point.
Lady Gaga.
Yes.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
So
I mean,
like,
did you see her meat costume? Like,
you. What? Okay, I'm not. Whatever. Anyways, who else we got? Who else we got? Madonna.
Yep.
Yes.
I'm gonna say no. Eminem? No.
No. That nigga doesn't give a fuck. He's just doing his own shit.
Yeah. Eminem,
he doesn't give a fuck. He's not involved in that shit. Nah.
Eminem, no.
Michelle Obama?
Fuck no.
Yes. She's a man.
Oh, what'd you say?
No,
would you just say, Matt?
She's a man. She's
gotta
a man.
Get off YouTube.
Matt, stay the fuck off the internet for a little bit. Fam, read her books.
Miley Cyrus?
Nah, bro.
No, hold on. Sorry.
Oh,
no,
yeah,
hold
yeah.
on. Sorry. Fam. No, I'm not debunking. No, hold
on. I know.
Read her books, fam.
I don't care.
I'm not even
books.
A book reader, and I actually read a bit of her book. Fam, no.
No, she's not a
No, I'm not rolling.
Come on, fam.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm not just doing that because she's a black woman. No, but I'm actually being serious.
Conspiracy managers go too far in sometimes.
Sorry, man.
So they just,
Do you want me to get you the book? When's your birthday again? Oh, it's by my birthday. Fuck, that's a long time for now.
You had James Gunn here, too.
Go ahead,
he's a director.
Sorry.
I don't know who James Gunn is.
No, he's just, it's okay.
Machine Gun Kelly?
Oprah.
Oh, Machine Gun Kelly and Megan Fox broke up.
Man, that's not important.
Really not important.
Oprah,
that's a hard one. I don't know. She's
I was going to
so,
say no at first, but then she has
so
enough money
up
to.
Up in that shit. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't want to say yes, but no, I don't want to
say
no.
Yes. I'm going to say yes on that one.
Yeah.
I'm going to say yes on that one.
Nail biter.
Paris Hilton.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck yeah. Skinny little
I don't
bitch.
I think she has no reason to be there. Rihanna.
I have a question. Wait. Let's pause right here for a second.
Mm hmm.
During the Super Bowl, she put up the
Rock Nation.
Yeah, the pyramid thing. Yeah,
that's called Rock Nation.
Okay, just want to make sure there's no Illuminati and someone's like.
Could be. I mean, that's a conspiracy shit, yeah, but that's Rock Nation. I can't with the conspiracy mans because they look into everything and they have the right. They have the right to do so. But
it's just too much.
Yeah,
that stresses me out.
No, the music industry is fucked.
It is
for sure.
Everybody that I've talked to or everybody that's been into it, they say it's fucked.
I feel like it's really just fucked. Anyone who has money and they're up in that realm of dollar amount or wealth, I feel like they're fried.
True.
At some point, certain people, not everybody, obviously. But yeah, I don't think it's just music industry. I think it's acting. I think it's a whole nine yards. There's so much bacchanal happening.
Hollywood in general.
They
yes,
got
good idea. Yeah.
Pharrell Williams. Come on. He's not on that. We got Prince.
Sorry.
Oh my God.
You got Prince Andrew and Prince Charles. Quentin Tarantino.
Prince Charles. I'm not surprised. Prince Charles,
for sure.
There was a fucking naked kid crawling out of the fucking Barcelona, whatever the fuck, 40. Palace it's called. Buckingham Palace. Like fucking
have
naked.
You guys watched the series on Netflix?
No.
Okay.
I'm not interested in that.
Cool.
Jay-Z?
I don't know. He's got a lot of money, a lot of power.
Money, just because you have a lot of money doesn't mean you're doing that shit. Yeah, it doesn't mean you're doing that. I feel like I'm going off the personality and like...
Or from what I've seen.
Exactly. Yeah. I'm going with the dollar amount still.
Sophie Trudeau. Know. Matt?
Yep.
Is she a man or?
She's just going along with Trudeau.
Got it.
Understand.
Jagmeet Singh?
Yeah, no. Obviously. Yeah.
No. Oh, not yeah. my man. No.
Oh, yeah.
Really? No, no, no. I'm not rolling.
It's not on the list. I just wanted to hear. I just wanted to hear, man.
That's crazy. No.
Oh, yeah. He would be on that list if he could.
Okay, so speaking of conspiracies, there's been a lot happening in the States. I'm going to hopefully let Matt take it away if he remembers what he was saying while we weren't recording. And, because it was really dope and interesting, but I want to see if he was paying attention
also
to
it. I want to update you guys before.
Oh, this is great.
Matt is on his final shot of Ray. He takes that next EP, so I'll be EP 90. That's great to end up. Yeah, that's great.
And then no more alcohol.
No more alcohol. That's crazy. But
I've been going to alcohol this year. It's my goal.
So if you wonder why Matt's kind of like, he had a shot of Ray and tequila stillies.
He ran out of Ray. So we had to do like a half. Yeah.
And I don't know if this is a thing or not, but sorry for the last episode if it was the audio.
No.
We're all good. We're good.
Don't worry.
Oh, Matt.
Edit.
Okay.
Matt. Take it away.
Matt, take it away.
All right. So if y'all have seen the news.
If you're going to tell a story, make sure
I haven't watched the news. Tell me about it.
So if y'all, I'm just going to run the story drop just because. Yo, so if y'all have been living under a rock, there's been a lot of quote unquote like UFO sightings. There's been like
balloons.
All this shit in the
Happy
air.
Birthday.
There's been like the Super Bowl performance. There's like this new Epstein list that just like supposedly is about to drop. There's a lot of news going on right now, but what's not getting talked about is what's going on in Ohio. And there's other train derailments that also happen around the country at the exact same time.
That's actually true.
There's even a truck in Arizona that I was carrying some other toxic chemical that fucking overturned. And this all happened within a matter of 5 days. Coincidence? I don't think so.
And all these chemicals, cancerous.
Cancerous, type 1 carcinogen, like the stuff that pretty much they burned off in Ohio into the atmosphere, is called vinyl chloride. Vinyl chloride is pretty much like when you burn it, it turns into the gas that they used in World War One, the mustard gas or whatever. That's pretty much what it turns into. So they burn that into the atmosphere, in like outside of town, like 5,000 people.
But it was a accident.
It was a controlled burn, and the derailment was apparently an accident, quote unquote. So
Siri, nice it.
Anyways, but when you look at it, they're pretty much the EPA which is the authority that pretty much says that. Like water quality is good, like air quality is good, all that kind of stuff. they pretty much told everybody in the town, yeah, everything's all good, everything's 100%.
Yeah.
And there's videos going around right now. There's people that are looking at the streams. They're completely contaminated.
It's contaminated.
Thousands of fish are dying.
It literally
people have mad headaches. They have like breathing problems right now. Yeah. There's like it's worse than it actually is being portrayed.
Wow.
So
why do you think that they are saying that it's okay, Matt?
They're pretty much saying it's okay to cover it up, because.
Do you think they're trying to kill off population?
Well, here's a story. If you look at the U.S. and you look at a map of the U.S., the highest Mormon population, so the people who didn't get the vax or didn't like pretty much like submit to all the bullshit that went on the past couple of years,
don't tell me so, yeah.
are located in like East Palestine, Ohio, like this area.
Wow.
And then where all the other train derailments happened, they're close to rivers and streams, and they're also same kind of thing, highest population of Mormons.
Interesting.
So Mormons, if you guys don't know, are people who are like don't use electricity. They don't subscribe to our systems, all that kind of stuff. They're kind of like they kind of live outside,
off the grid,
from all of us. So, wow. So the
learning today.
The theory is they're trying to get them somehow. They're pretty much trying to poison these people somehow or get them to, you know what I mean, like. So
leave me alone.
But the overarching theme, you don't have fucking 5 train derailments of toxic waste in a fucking week. You don't.
That's
there was one in North Carolina. Ohio.
That's when you had a question, in like, Arizona, how safe is a train then? Like,
in,
if that's really happening.
In Arizona, there was a truck that fucking tipped over, toxic waste again. Mm-hmm. And then there was another one in one other state. I can't remember what it was. But all close to major waterways. Like, the Ohio River is close to, like, where it feeds into the Mississippi, mm-hmm. I believe. Don't quote me on that.
Jeez.
But, yeah, all these waterways, man, it's just, like, it's contamination, man.
It's sad.
And people are going to get really sick. And we're not going to see the effects for, like, a couple of years. People like getting cancer and shit, so it's big, man. So this is all getting pushed under the rug, and they're saying like it's okay. Like the government is pretty much saying like, yeah, all these people are okay and everything like that. And then the news on the ground is like, nah, we're not okay. Like, what the fuck are they saying?
That's crazy. That's why the news is crazy. This is why I kind of get annoyed when the news, like, I'm watching the news too much. I try to disconnect myself sometimes from what's really happening, but it is good to know what's happening.
Yeah.
So, like, educate yourself, of course, but I just get really bothered and annoyed by what's going on sometimes. It's like, yo, I just can't. Mm. I have more than enough to take on right now. I can't hear this right now.
Yeah.
I can't. It's annoying. It's just so sad. It's really, really sad what's really being put under the rug and what's really being amplified to the world.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
It's crazy. So.
Would you rather know or not know? So, like, how they are going about it?
I can understand from their perspective. They're trying to make sure that people don't panic, because we're technically in Ontario. We're right beside Ohio. So
that's what I'm saying. We're not that far away.
So pretty much when they did that controlled burn and all of that carcinogen and all those fucking chemicals went into the atmosphere, our weather systems move. They move everything around.
Yeah, it's true.
So
a storm that happens in Florida can also, like, affect us as well too. So
yeah, and then stuff that gets picked up, like water and all this stuff, that gets picked up one place, it gets dropped in another place. So, yeah, so they're pretty much saying the news. They're really like, yeah, everything's okay. Like, you don't even worry about it. But
to answer D's question, I'd rather know.
You'd rather know.
I'd rather know, so
you can shelter in place.
I can make my decision on what I want to do. You're supposed to be in the news and supposed to be informing me about what's happening. Mm-hmm. What's happening? So we can make a decision so it's better for our health and our population. Yeah, Matt, we'll continue on to the next one.
I think that is super fucked up about... what's happening in Ohio. Prayers to Ohio and the residents out there, just because they did it in also such a place where they're not going to react as fast.
No, stuff, they don't have the resources to react that quickly.
There's only 5,000 people in East Palestine.
It's damn near similar to Flint. Like, the water in Flint is still
really bad.
Fucked.
Really, really bad.
It's just, we're going to get into the stuff.
The U.S. gave $40 billion. Or for whatever it is.
To Ukraine?
Yeah. And we can't even fix
this
problems
is what
here.
I was talking about earlier.
Sorry.
And you can't even fix problems back home.
Praise to Ukraine. But
of course, I completely agree, for sure. Oh, my God. I'm annoyed.
But places like Turkey need the money more. I'm just going to say it.
Yeah.
Right? They're only going to Ukraine and giving Ukraine so much money just because it's, like, it's white. Like, people there, and, you know, we had to keep everything in Europe afloat because there's a power structure. So, yeah, let's give money there. But high key, if the government was to put money into these other countries and stuff and fund them, we build that relationship, we get more resources. Like, it's just crazy that this is happening.
I know we're going to move on to the balloon thing, but one thing I want to say is, like, do you really think the government has our best interest? Like, quick takes.
Nope.
Matt.
Just cap.
The government doesn't give a shit about you.
Hold on. Let me get this drop for Cardell right here.
And this is why, for the last, like, 10 pods, ever since DB brought it up about just not being involved in, like, within, like, this area, like, within Canada, within the United States, and just going somewhere else, I'm feeling it a lot more as time goes by. Like, it's making a lot more sense to me of why I would want to leave. Like,
yeah,
it's crazy. But
I didn't want to go there every episode. I didn't want to get back.
Yeah, that's just a quick tick. Yeah.
Okay.
That's so frustrating.
I try not to keep thinking that it's the United States anniversary every year or a birthday every day. So we're gonna let Matt break it down for us. This is a great intro to a great topic that I feel like Matt will fucking update us and the listeners. Matt, take it away.
All right. So if y'all hadn't heard in the news, it's been all over the news. Mm-hmm. Unlike East Palestine, there was pretty much, it started out with a Chinese spy balloon which is what they're calling it, allegedly. U.S. decided to shoot it down. I believe that was somewhere in the States. Can't remember exactly what state it was.
Yeah.
Same thing happened a couple weeks or like a week ago in Alaska, where they had like quote unquote UFO that was flying over, got shot down. Again, same thing. But yeah, this happened a number of times. Same thing.
It's a number of times. What do you mean? It's more than twice?
Yeah, more than twice. So in the last week, there's been like 3 or 4 balloons are like UFOs.
Balloon-like objects.
Yeah. Balloon-like objects and UFOs, apparently.
And a question?
Yeah.
Did they find like the wreckage of whatever they're...
Oh, no.
They're doing that right now. They're apparently investigating. The one that got shot down in the Yukon... They're investigating it.
I've heard is that they haven't been able to find debris or shit. But I also think that goes to what Matt was saying about Ohio. Everything's fine, guys. Everything's okay. It's just balloons.
Yeah, you gotta take everything that government says with a grain of salt.
Grain of salt.
You have to take it with a grain of salt.
Yeah.
You can't fully believe anything that the government says because they're not trying to cause panic and they're literally trying to like keep everything under control.
And so. Goes back to my question. Would you want to know where?
I want to know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sell my house. I'm gone.
Oh, it don't matter. It don't matter. If it's the UFOs, it really don't matter. It really don't matter. Like
facts, but yeah. I want to disconnect myself from this shit. I want to, when I'm in Trinidad, all the other places, I disconnect myself from whatever's happening back home. Mm-hmm. This is a great place to live. Great healthcare, although all 9 years, but just getting worse and worse. And I'm just getting annoyed by it.
Thoughts on it?
Yeah, so it was 4 total flying objects, is what they're calling it.
Fam. And right. Everything's fine. Everything's good, right?
Yeah.
Just it's all good. We're not getting bombed. Nothing's happened. We're good.
The U.S. cares more about these fucking balloons that are no threat to anything versus like fucking the shit they decided to burn off in Ohio.
Fam.
For sure.
They can find a flipping. You said you couldn't find the wreckage.
But
they can go underwater and find a fucking boat that sank 40 fucking kilometers down, but they can't find something shot down? Get the fuck out of my face. There's a GPS location where the fucking plane was when it shot it. So find it within that fucking 50 kilometer radius.
Yeah.
It's called Mayday. You ever heard of Mayday before, the damn TV show? How can they find records like so? But you can't find a fucking thing you shot down. Get the fuck out of my face.
Yeah.
This is bullshit. I vex. Yes, you tell. I'm upset. Fuck, man.
Yeah. I don't.
Oh, cap.
I think it's only just gonna keep going. I do think that some of them are just people fucking with the government.
Yes.
I'm gonna add that in.
Yes.
Yeah. Because right? Why not?
Yeah. Why not?
The balloons. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Why
but
not?
I do think.
Make it interesting.
I do think the first original one
was
Chinese.
Yeah,
right?
I think so too.
And with the whole, they said that they didn't want to shoot it in one place. Because they don't know what will come out of it, which might
you don't
be
know where it's gonna go left, right, or go into a populated area.
You shoot it down, disease spreads, kind of thing. So they were just being iffy on like what to do with that kind of thing.
But then let it fly, and then it goes into a populated area like town square, New York.
They control burn of vinyl chloride in Palestine with 5,000 people, so they obviously don't give a fuck about people.
That's crazy, bro. There's so much bacchanal in my brain right now, and there's so much things to think about, and like these kind of things. Like now that I'm looking at it, like now that I'm being introduced, because this podcast, shout out to Roundtable Talk, you already know what it is. Shout out to the boys because they're informing me.
Keep it real,
fam. These are things you gotta think about, like really on some shit. You gotta think of this, like actually.
You gotta at the end of
what's
the day.
What's the future
looking like?
You
gotta look out for yourself at the end of the day.
Yeah, you matter. I matter. You matter. You matter. The viewers matter.
The aliens are outside.
God. Yeah.
Who do we show them first? Matt?
Where's Johnny?
He
left already? Johnny already left? Where's Kessel? See? Kessel Johnny already gone. They already know.
Yo, fam. I'll introduce myself
For sure, Matt.
Aliens come down that are just like, yo, take me to your leader. Who do you take them to?
Yo, me.
The white guy.
Okay. Yeah. I was going to say Drake, but we need Drake more than Matt.
The white guy. Take him first. See what happens. Take me to your leader. Toy Story. Take me to your leader.
5 minutes later, they send him back.
Yeah.
We don't need him.
Spit him out.
He doesn't qualify.
He can't cook.
He doesn't taste good.
He doesn't taste good. There's no seasoning in him. He doesn't taste good.
Wait. Matt says, "What is this damn chicken?" What is Matt's white chicken he fucking making, fam? Oh my god!
Yo, drop the recipes down below. Drop some recipes down below for the white man on the pod
again.
My gosh.
Link in the fucking comments.
I'll read all the comments and
link
yo.
In the comments of your favorite dishes to make, fam. I want to start making some new shit.
Yeah.
Where is this podcast going?
I don't know.
No, okay. Anyways.
This is roundtable. It goes every single direction.
Anyways, and speaking of that, I'm sending it to Cods with his topic list now.
Who's below the table?
So we wanted to get into Apple being a finesse.
Shit.
Buying extra things for each.
Extra accessories.
Accessories for each product.
Cordell, I'm a flipping sucker. I'm going to call that from right now. I am a sucker when it comes to like just Apple. I want you guys to know I used to hate Apple. I used to despise Apple. Fam.
Still do for me.
I got talked into getting an iPhone, and since then I've been hooked. But I feel like all their products are so expensive, and like they take away stuff. For example, when I got my first iPhone, it came with headphones, came with a block charger, came with a wire. Ooh. Fast forward about 6-7 years, bam, you're lucky to even get the fucking phone in the box. The hell?
Hey.
You gotta buy the box first. You gotta buy the box first. Like, what? Fam,
for real though.
How do you sell a fucking phone with no cube? How's that an extra charge? Yeah. Explain to me.
They expect you have a cube.
Because the cube. No, man, you're not getting it. The cube changed. So you have to buy a new one. They changed it. It's not the USB one anymore.
So it's USB-C.
The
new,
yeah.
It's USB-C.
How do you do that?
Yeah, I noticed that.
Another example. I have a 2017 MacBook. Have all the connections. I can plug in anything the fuck I want.
Turtle, slow down.
Sorry. I can plug in anything I want into my 2017 MacBook. But now, DV got the 2023 off the lot. Dizzy Basil. All the gold and shit. But guess what? My man has to buy adapters to start plugging shit into your charger's fucking phone.
Yeah. HDMIs. Yeah. I don't even like that.
Why
shit
is
too.
Apple doing this? Like, what do you guys see the future of Apple really being doing this? Like, they're just going to keep taking stuff away?
They're money hungry. It's profit hungry. So
do you see their facilities?
By getting rid of that block, it eliminates production cost. So they made a shitload of money by eliminating that. And now that they sell the laptops with all the accessories, they have a markup on each one of the accessories because that used to be included.
I got mad on this one. I think it's market control.
Yeah.
And also for each product that they like make up out of the, we're going to do this now instead.
Yeah. It's an extra.
Guess who else has to adapt to it? The little convenience stores, the Walmarts that also want to do it too.
That's a fact.
And
they have to buy all the extra accessories.
Not done.
You are right.
Also, this product that we just made, we're going to trademark it. So now you guys have, when you guys want to remix it, you can remix it.
Yeah, we got to.
You got to. So that's why I think of market control. And I don't know if that's the thing.
It does boil back to what Matt said. They're just trying to make more money.
Hell yeah.
But I feel like that should be in somewhat. See, this is what I'm talking about. Companies should get charged for that kind of shit. And I feel like there's one state or
Brazil.
One place. Yes.
Brazil is the country.
Are they suing?
I think they won that.
I think, yeah, they won that. Fam. You cannot.
Matt, search in the meantime. Brazil versus Apple.
What's the word I'm looking for? It's unprepared. It's like you buy a car, but there's no fucking wheels.
No tires and stuff. Yeah.
What the fuck kind of shit is this?
Yeah.
How the fuck am I gonna charge my phone if I buy
Brazil fines Apple $19 million for continuing to sell iPhones without a charger.
That's a low end too.
That is absolutely disrespectful.
Yeah. A Brazilian court today levied a $19 million social damages fine, $100 million so it's $100 million in Brazilian money against Apple for selling iPhones without a charger, reports Reuters. The Sao Paulo State Court said that Apple must offer battery chargers with iPhones that are sold in the country.
I agree.
Providing a decision in a lawsuit brought about by the Brazilian Association of Borrowers, Consumers, and Taxpayers.
I agree.
Big W. Clapping for them. That's a W.
You should get in trouble for that shit. Huh? I'm spending, yo.
Trudeau whenever.
Yeah, right. These things cost anywhere from $15,000 to $2,000, and you're telling me I don't get a charger?
Yeah, that's nuts. That's nuts. Like, if you're going to take out the charger, at least give me the screen protector.
Fam. Something. Yeah, give me some headphones. I have, fam.
Yeah, headphones.
Remember when a phone came with headphones?
Oh, my god!
I think it was so long ago.
That was so fire.
When you opened the phone package, you had headphones. You had two chargers. You had one charger for this, one charger for that.
You were good.
You had extra buds.
You were good. You were good. You were set.
Came with, like, a cleaner, too. Like, yeah, you were set.
Extra. Fam, the box is so tiny. Right when you open the damn box, it's, like, literally the outline of the phone. You take the phone out. There's nothing else in the box.
You're like, this is what I paid fucking $1,000 for. Like,
oh wait, you guys didn't even give me instructions on how to use a phone. You guys took that away. Okay,
go online. No, they're gonna tell you use your phone. Go online. I love you, Apple. You guys are great. You guys are fucking great. You guys are great.
It's such a.
One thing I like is your fucking warranty. And guess what? Anytime you buy a damn phone, you still gotta buy another warranty on top of it. What kind of bacchanal is this? I bought the thing once. Give me the thing already.
It's nuts. It doesn't make any sense. I don't like it either. And I'm still on the side that Androids and Google Pixel phones are like super dope.
No.
But I'm stuck.
I'm gonna stay with my Apple.
I'm stuck. They're better, but I'm stuck.
I'm stuck with the Apple shit. They draw me in. They got me. I have an iMac. I have a MacBook. I got the AirPods. I got the fucking watch. I got the phone.
Yeah, you and that.
I got fake AirPods for $30 on Amazon.
Oh, I'm not doing that.
Be like that.
I'm not doing that.
Cod's your topic list now.
All right. There's been a lot of shit been going on between. Well, it's been going a lot from last year. It's been going a lot this year as well too. It's getting worse and worse.
What shit?
Car thefts.
Yeah.
Car thefts have been getting out of hand in the GTA, fam.
If you have a push to start car,
even over. Obviously, this is gonna be weeks from when you guys see this, but just the other day, one of my friends reposted something and I felt like, yo, I need to repost because this is within Mississauga and I live in Mississauga. Brand new 2022 whip stolen in within 30 seconds.
Oh, that's brand new.
Even what Mao's even showing me today. $150,000 F-350 stolen 30 seconds.
Right out of the driveway.
This is exactly why people like will say to me, like, yo, Quero, you're extra for putting the lock thing on your tire. You're extra for putting the thing on your steering wheel. Fam.
Do you know what age we're living in? We're living in an age of inflation.
I want to be the next one. I'm going to try my best. You can smash up my car. Great. But leave it there. Please.
Yeah, at least, thank you. At least I can get it fixed through insurance.
Please, thank you.
I have it on video and shit. Yeah.
Honestly, I didn't think video doesn't matter anymore. I feel like they're not even putting masks on anymore. They don't give a fuck. They're not going to get caught. I promise you. They don't give a fuck.
Well, since this is the whole like report on pod kind of thing, for the Von Mills incident, They caught two out of the three.
Wow.
And they reported that, like, the picture of, of the third person. Manny's like, man, do you have, like, Kleenex? Do you know how to use it? Never mind. It's okay. They showed the picture of the third suspect, and they legit just said, like, yo, we know what you look like. You might as well just come in.
They
said, get a lawyer.
We're coming for your ass.
And no, just you should come to us. You should come to us. Turn yourself in.
Tactics.
Because, we have two out of the three, so. But, yeah, continue.
It's crazy. Do you guys remember the day and age where, like, bike thefts used to be a thing? Car thefts never used to be that crazy. You remember, like, when you could be able to, like, park your car in your driveway, lock it, and walk in your house? Do you remember how, like, nowadays, every time I wake up, it's like a 50-50 if like my car's gonna be there or not. That's crazy. I'm double checking before I go to the house.
I like beep the car like four times. Like,
why? There's so many things I have to deal with within my life, but and I gotta worry about my vehicle sitting on my property and on my shit I pay for.
Yo, yeah. So crazy stat I just pulled up.
Oh, this is great.
Here we go. In Toronto alone, more than 8,000 vehicles were reported stolen over the past year, and that's 2022, and that's up from 5,600 the previous year in 2021. So that's literally like a 3,000 car increase.
Whoa!
In a year. So 8,000 cars in Toronto were stolen.
That's just in one end,
in 2022.
Fam.
Damn.
Think about
how many cars 8,000 is. That's parking lots. That's parking lots of cars.
Jeez.
That's a lot of fucking vehicles. And you know what's crazy too? Some people are like, they take it seriously, like, oh, well, if they steal it, they steal it. But it's just like, yo. No, I've talked to people and I'm like, yo, because I have tools. I literally have a box where I put my keys in now. Where the signal is cut. There's no signal to my car. But now they got smarter now. Guess what? They break into your car. They plug it into the OBD reader. Beep, bop, boop, bop, 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 beep, bop, bop. Thing starts. Huh? So now what? You don't need a key? They have a boop, bop. They got a boobop. What?
A boobop.
Bam. You know what my boys told me? You know the light in your license plate cover? Like, you know how your license plate has lights?
Yeah. Okay.
They take the ball belt, plug into that.
What?
Yeah, your shit's gone.
Dog.
The only thing you can do is block your car in. That's all you can really do.
That's nuts.
That's all you can do is block your shit in. And that's why I got the wheel lock. That's why I got
I'm thinking about doing the same thing.
The club? The club? I never thought in my life I would actually use a club. And guess what? I got to use one.
Yeah.
I understand that it may not be coming from my shit, but I don't want to be that sucker, unfortunately.
I don't know.
But what if they just take out the steering wheel?
Then they're not going to have a steering wheel. But what they would do, and obviously it's going to take them longer, and they don't want to take long to seal a car, obviously.
That's true.
They're going to try cutting it. Yeah. They're going to try cutting these things off, but that's risking it. So they're probably going to look at your shit, be like, fuck.
What's it for the viewers, what's more affordable? Getting one of those things that you put on your...
Give us some advice.
We're actually going to be doing, and like, we haven't done this at all, but we're gonna try something. And because we care for our viewers, we care for our people, and we want to make sure no one gets their whip stolen, we're actually going to be dropping the link for a couple of the tools I use on my personal vehicle. And you guys can go through the links and buy some stuff. So we can start with number one, the club. Simple enough, you put it on your steering wheel, making sure your whip doesn't get stolen.
Yeah.
Okay.
Number two, get the wheel lock. Fam, if a man walks up to you, if you walk up to a car and see a wheel lock, you're like, nigga, I ain't taking this shit. We can take the wheel off. Okay. So we'll link that too. Okay. And number three, probably one of the most important things that people sleep on.
Mm-hmm.
People have scanners in their pockets.
Okay.
So when they pass you, they can see your information.
Yeah.
So my wallet is protected.
RFID wallets.
There you go. I'm going to be linking those as well too. And also the bag. There's a bag I'm going to put on the screen as well too. There's a bag you can put your keys in. Locks off all communication from your key to your car.
Beauty.
Because that's exactly how they'd be seeing the majority of them. Majority of them are literally walking to your house, putting some little 1-2 like radio thing up, getting the signal. Walk up to your whip.
That's crazy.
That's it. That's what crazy fucked. Technology is. Beep, bop, boop, bop.
Yo, so do you got a link to that box?
I'm going to put everything in the description, and we're going to get it popping because I care for my viewers. I care for my people. I don't want to see people get their whip stolen because, again, people work hard for this shit.
It's a stress going through insurance to try and get that back and shit. Especially if you don't have video footage.
My neighbor across the street, it's been 6 months. He's gave up.
Damn.
Didn't find the whip, and he has to pay his $1,000 deductible. Your whip got stolen, but you got to pay your $1,000 deductible. How does that make? Because he doesn't have footage.
That's fucked.
Wow.
It's crazy out here. And, like, things are getting more expensive. Things are getting more crazy. Like, you just got to protect your shit. I understand things are hard for people. I understand why people are doing it. But, come on.
Yeah, we're in a recession right now. You got to be smart.
It's rough. It's rough out here.
Speaking of cars, is that true about the cops getting that new... No, right? Okay, it's fake news.
Oh, the Corvette?
That's just
It was just the auto show.
That's for the auto show.
Thank you. Thank God. Because I was really about to say, y'all niggas asked for this fucking dollars, and y'all did that?
Yeah, that's actually very
so
true.
That's
TV.
What I was just going to be like, okay, back home.
That's 100K. That's 100K.
There's some other news. I saw the other day that the cops have this new technology they've been trying out.
Talk about it.
For license plate reading.
Talk about it, Matt.
Pretty much all they do is they sit in their car with their technology, and as cars pass, the technology literally, it's like one of those things on the Tesla for auto driving and shit. It just reads the license plate really quick and like picks them out and is like, yo, pull this person over.
It basically tells
you. Expired license plates.
Exactly. It tells you if it's expired license plate, if your car has insurance or no insurance.
Yeah.
Don't sleep. I hope
licensed,
you guys know.
If the driver's licensed.
I'm pretty sure on this stat, there's about 45% of people who don't have insurance and are driving.
Hey, shout out to y'all.
That is a risky business.
It is super risky.
Well, dude, the girl. So if you guys don't know, I rented this girl. It was decently bad on my part. But there's like
it was worse for Matt than it was.
There was barely any damage to her car. She gave me a fucking expired fucking insurance slip for Enterprise.
So you ass.
She had an Alberta license plate.
So didn't you ass.
Gave me a fake number.
So you ass.
All this shit. So yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking,
people be out here driving with no insurance and shit.
It's crazy.
Okay, on the maybe after the pod we'll talk about
but
this.
Two out of three of us have been in that same situation where I've been in an accident and the guy didn't have proper insurance the whole 9 yards. So take that in. So it does happen a lot. It does happen a lot. And like I understand it's expensive to have insurance, but it's necessary to have
it's a requirement.
Yes, a $5,000 ticket if you get pulled over. So guess what? Beep, bop, boop, bop, bop, bop. You go by the cop, it's GG for your life. 5 G's?
Okay.
Now, if you didn't have money for insurance, you ain't going to have money for that damn ticket.
Okay.
I like this. I like. I always thought the cops been had that little device.
No, they've, so I could kind of explain.
They've
it.
Been testing it, but yeah, Cordell.
I can kind of explain it. So when you do get pulled over, they don't know nothing. They don't know nothing. All they know is anything about the vehicle. They don't know anything about you.
Okay.
So once they pull up and you get their license, they can either click on your name and go through all the information. That's why sometimes it takes long for a cop to come back to you because they're reading through your information, seeing your prior, seeing whatever.
Right.
Obviously, if you don't have anything, they'll come back quicker for okay. whatever the reasons for getting pulled over. But as they're pulling up on you, they don't know nothing. They don't know you even have insurance or not. They don't know anything about anything. They just have the plate number and that's it.
Okay, true.
So that's the crazy part. Cops don't know that much.
Do you think that this device is better or worse?
Well, as a car guy, I think it's better.
Me too.
I think it's better.
I think less like racial.
Yes.
Kind of stops, you know. So.
Yes. 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 Yes.
But will it still show you?
Is it shows the owner of the vehicle off the plate?
Owner, male, female, kind of thing.
Yes, okay. And then shows owner and. It's going to show if you have insurance or not, which is the most important thing. And right. if your stickers are, your plate is required to be on the road right now.
Yo, so this video from the OPP. So the OPP, the system flagged 32 vehicles in 22 minutes. 32 vehicles in 22 minutes.
Yo.
All they were doing was sitting on the side of the road. They were conducting another traffic stop. The system identified one suspended driver, four unlicensed drivers, and 27 expired vehicle registrations.
Fam, that's just so stupid. If I don't have to put a sticker on my vehicle, why can't just stay? If it's free, then why I gotta keep doing it?
Yeah.
What's the point?
You have to keep renewing it like online.
What's the point?
Don't know what the point
See
is.
See the nonsense? It's free now. So why am I got to go back on a computer?
It used to be a moneymaker. The licensing system is just for the government to make money. That's all it's for.
Yeah.
But the fact they got rid of it, so why do I got to continue? Because I just bought my new car and I'm like, fuck, I don't have a sticker on my car. They forgot to put it on. I'm like, wait, I don't need one anymore.
All you have to do is go online and register. It's free.
Why? What?
I know.
Compliance.
I had a ticket.
Compliance.
What a stupid ticket.
Compliance. That's all it is.
It's free, but if I get caught not doing it, it's $127.
Yeah,
crazy.
It doesn't make any sense.
It's a finesse. It's a jug.
Big finesse.
It's a jug as hell. But that new system, hey, I know put license plate covers on. They can't read it.
Okay, beautiful. Link those as well.
That's facts. Put license plate cover on. Beautiful.
And also, hold a fake ID, just in case you get into a little onto a fender bender.
Facts. Facts. And you know another little getaway trick? On Amazon, you can order something where
I love how we're giving tips.
I did it. I'm just giving you all tips.
Oh, yeah, same.
I've never done it. Yeah. If you guys are ever taking the 407, before you get
Don't give up that one. Relax.
No, hit him.
You said yourself you wouldn't say it on the pod. Don't do that.
Say it.
You don't know what I'm going to say.
All right, go ahead. I know
there's
exactly
a license plate that you can get, and you press a button, and it covers your license plate. You go on, you press the button, it goes back up.
Yes.
You exit the
house. Yes. Hell yeah. I'm buying that first.
That's not a bad thing.
I'm buying that first.
Bam. All right. Come on now. Use your platform responsibly.
What's your full name again?
I don't remember. I didn't say I did it.
It's mostly Canadian.
My whips don't have it. You can't check my whips. I don't have it, so it's okay. I'm just giving y'all little timbits.
Holy shit!
Trying to finesse the sip a little bit. They're making money off of us, bear.
I like when we do guest pods and then we come back to the family.
The 3-man pods. Yeah, this is stupid.
I know. Yeah, just us. Just catching our listeners on just the shit that's happening and it's
facts.
Dope.
It's crazy.
But yeah. Do you have anything else you want to get into? Or?
Hold up. I can barely see Matt's finger. I didn't know what you were saying, a minute or two. Just the last thing I have is the... I have a theory about Valentine's Day. I was really curious about this. I was really, really curious about this.
Let's get into minor cards.
I know we talked about a little bit with Johnny when we were on that last EP or the EP before that. But I have a theory that Valentine's Day, for us men, we're not going to be looking at it as a serious flex. I don't think we're going to be taking it seriously with our sureties. Between the next like 5 to 10 years, it won't be as serious as it is now.
What?
It's declining. I feel like it's slowly declining because I be seeing stuff like when I'm watching some of the YouTubers that I watch, they're even talking about for their girls, like they're doing the little things, like the card of how much I appreciate you and the flowers. That's it. They're not doing the crazy dinners. They're not doing the gifts. I feel like on Valentine's Day, I don't think there should be a gift. And the thing that they're preaching the most is that's what I'm thinking about, and I've been preaching this too, is we don't need this one day that someone created how long ago to show our love and appreciation for someone. I feel like that should be on an everyday basis.
Okay, but let's stay on the theory. Yeah. We all agree, but let's stay on your theory.
But the theory is, yeah. I feel like, for example, I'll give you an example, Halloween. I feel like Halloween has died down so much over the last, obviously something completely different, but I feel like as kids, I feel like that was such a big thing and the streets used to be packed when it came to it. Mm-hmm. And it's been dying down over the last little bit. And the same thing with Valentine's Day, I feel like more men are realizing like, this is just the stupidest fucking shit ever. It's just an overpriced day to spend money. It's a money grab. It's a little finesse. Okay. And then I'll give you an example. Mm-hmm. I actually went up to Valentine's Day with my good boy Johnny. Hold on. Don't go crazy in the comments. I also went out with one of my really, really good friends, Chelsea, as well, too.
I'm clipping that and taking out Chelsea.
Yeah, on you. I'm going to make a clip and then repost it after you post that one.
Go ahead.
We sat down, and mind you, I checked the menu before, and obviously these places do these prefix menus. And I was like, you know what? I just want to get a pizza tonight. And the guy's like, nope, sorry, sir. Per couple, it's $160. I said, oh, hell. Well, okay. Here goes nothing. But I was like, well, it's three of us, so what's going to happen? He's like, oh, $80 each. I said, bet. Well, let's check this menu out.
Okay.
Four-course meal. Okay? Don't get me wrong. Food was all right. Food was all right. Mm-hmm. But the fact that I can't even pick what I want to eat tonight on this special day, but you have a menu prepared for me, I don't like that.
Okay.
These places are just literally just trying to make...
Keep going. No.
Money off of the aspect if it's Valentine's Day.
Okay. So I want to... You're pivoting. I want to stay on your theory, though.
Of the 10-year thing?
Of, yeah. Because I get it, though. So,
just get me out the door.
Matt, your thoughts on just Valentine's Day dying down kind of thing?
You mean Singles Awareness Day?
Singles Awareness Day? Is that what that is?
Okay. Matthew, you're some gunshots for yourself, Matt. Shit. Lose my voice.
Fire.
Yeah.
Yeah, but what are your thoughts on it, yo?
I think I'm with Cordell in the aspect that, like, if you love that girl or if she's your girl, like, you should be celebrating her every single day. Like, don't wait till February 14th just to show her how much you appreciate her.
It's a gross day.
Okay, I feel like Valentine's Day is a competition to see, like, whose man did more. Also.
Between the girls?
Yeah.
Like,
between the girls. IG games. Yeah, just IG games, right?
Yeah. It's true. You're right.
And also, I'm rolling with cards, but I also think that the mans that are new to relationships or trying to get into one with someone or just like someone will celebrate it more than the guys who just been holding it down.
Yeah. Oh, that's very true.
So I don't think it's dying down. I think it's dying down in certain pockets in certain areas.
For sure.
I like the Halloween comparison, and it's a fact.
I just feel like this year I just heard a lot more men just speaking on like, yo, I'm not doing nothing. I just heard, I've spoke to a couple of women, I spoke to a couple of men, because I really wanted to know, like, where everyone was at when it came to it. Mm. Personally, for me, I hate that day. I hate that day. I hate it. It's the most ridiculous thing ever.
Yeah,
it's embarrassing, actually.
If you've been listening to us pre-pandemic, we've been saying, like, yo, Valentine's Day is just a weird day. And
usually we have little hearts and stuff on the thing. We just said, no, we're not even doing that, bro. Like, run that, bro.
Yeah, I'm cool.
Don't without that, bro.
No, we didn't do no hearts for Valentine's
Day. I don't mind just getting my shorty some flowers.
Valentine's Day.
I don't mind getting some flowers and some chocolate.
And some dick!
That too. Oh, yeah. That's a day where, like, you know, shorty, hey.
Go to 7-Eleven for the flowers.
Hey, you're learning, man.
Don't pull a Johnny and go to the florist for $160. Don't do that. They don't do all that. They die in 4 days. Don't do that. This is stupid. See? Finesse.
And the team might not even show up.
Facts.
Like, what the fuck?
Another thing too.
What are you talking about?
I went to the florist. I went to Sobeys to get some flowers. Fam, there was easy 30 mans in line, two shorties.
Dude, I went to the grocery store on Valentine's Day. Same thing. They had a massive thing of flowers, all gone.
Crazy line.
All of them are gone.
Crazy line. I'm like, fam, I don't need these wrapped. I'm cashing out. I don't care. Wrapped?
Yeah. What?
Craziness.
I'll wrap my car, but I'm not wrapping those flowers.
Craziness though. But speaking on what D just said, when it comes to shorty giving you some pokes on that quote unquote special day, is it important for your shorty to know what you like? So, is it important for your shorty to know what kind of porn you like and to study it?
Let's get it, man.
You think it's a good idea or a bad idea to show her?
Not
like send
good,
that shit.
It's a good idea so she can replicate it for you.
Yo,
especially you got those fantasies where you're like, hey, what if I bring another girl in mix?
Fire.
But, see how quick you're gonna fucking lose her. If you, I feel
nah,
like
some girls are actually cool with that.
Sorry,
you some, are not that guy.
Some girls I've talked to have actually been cool with that.
And are they in a relationship? With
if they're in a relationship with their man, some of them actually want another
female.
Are okay with another female?
So
oftentimes those girls are bi. By the way,
Cordell falls for this every time. You're learning. We're just talking, Matt. Don't believe it.
When it really boils down to it,
they won't do it.
They won't do it.
And they'll fold and they'll talk it.
They'll talk it just because like
cool conversation.
But I don't think so.
No,
unless it's a porn star.
Fam, I'm not dating. We talked about this. We're not dating a porn star. Yeah, unless you are, that's fine with you, but I ain't doing that. What the hell?
Yeah, we had the whole conversation.
You did?
No, me and you had
the
whole
conversation. Oh, we did? Yeah.
It's okay. We'll leave that alone.
Yeah,
we'll leave that alone.
Yeah,
but
we'll leave that alone.
To go back to that question, you know what? Okay, so I see both sides. Because if you show her like the porn that you like, and stuff, right? Or like not even the category. Sorry, let's talk about the video themselves.
Okay,
and you could be like, "Yo, see how she's slurping with the Glock 3000?
Yeah,
twist, double twist, hand work.
Yeah, the
with the fucking
twist on top. Yeah,
and when she's playing the fucking eye games and she's not blinking at.
Get some tongue in there.
You show her that she tries to do it on you, it could go. Two ways. Yeah, it could go extremely really like bad. How you thought it was going
to
go.
I've had to instruct a girl on how to fucking give head in a hand job.
No, what?
She went in way too hard. Like, she went in, like, gripping
I've been gripping it,
and I was like, yo, I cannot feel my blood fucking going into my fucking piece right now.
I'm going to double back.
You're strangling my little man down there.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Unfortunately, I'm at the double back.
What?
I hate this.
Oh, I didn't want you. I thought you were going to say it here. You sure?
I'm going to say it.
Right. Give Cordell 30 seconds on why DB was right. Go ahead.
I hate this.
Go ahead.
It's good he's my best friend. I was wrong. DB was right.
What was I right about?
Damn it. Stupid drop. Wife the hoe.
Matt, I don't know if you remember, but we had that conversation about would you wife a hoe?
We got into it.
Yeah.
That was a garage pod.
Garage pod.
Me and Evie actually got, we were actually going back and forth on that one. Very on the side of I'm not wifing a hoe. I'm not wifing a fucking hoe. If you've been ran through that, no, I don't want you. I want the good.
She doesn't need to be ran through. She just needs to know what she's doing.
Yeah,
she knows what she's doing, but fam, what does that come with? Experience. Mm-hmm. Anything you do, Matt, you've been doing this podcast for 3 years.
She could have experience with one partner and still be fucking phenomenal.
sorry. Keep going.
Matt, you've been doing this podcast for 3 years. You get better and better with new lighting, new this, new camera. You're expanding with what you know and your knowledge of what you need to get done.
Yep.
It comes with the same thing when fam, if she doesn't know how to twerk, now she's gonna learn how to twerk throughout, and knew she's gonna learn from other mans as well too.
Mm-hmm.
So, fam, unfortunately, DV was right.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Let's talk about it.
I'm so sad. But I hate when DV's right.
To go back to what Cordell was originally talking about, and thank you, I'll give you a props for that.
Whatever.
Okay, but no. And then the other part is, yo, she starts doing this shit, and it's way worse. And you have to tell her, don't actually just stop.
Yeah,
and it's an awkward thing, and that's why Cordell mentioned the whole thing, because you avoid that altogether. Because she's doing everything and more.
Hundreds. Hundreds.
Never expect.
Exactly.
Wow.
Hundreds.
Oh my gosh.
Shout out to the girls. Shout out to the girls.
I didn't even know I could not like that. Excuse me.
It's a fucking waterfall. It's like I'm peeing.
Yeah. The fuck? I feel like a fucking great whale. Fuck is you talking about? What?
I hate Navy. No, but real shit though. I feel like it is. I just want to say shout out to the girls that like take that shit seriously. Like they're actually like, yo, I really love pleasing my man. I shout out to y'all. Shout out to y'all, so. Shout out to y'all.
I love pleasing women.
Nah, it's been a minute, so I'm sure you do. Matt's gonna fuck some shit up. Next time, next time, hey Matt. Single ladies. Matt's single. Hit him up. You don't see the thirst traps he's dropping? You see the fucking pick he dropped? Yeah. Huh?
Matt has dollars too, eh?
What?
So.
Soon. But yeah. don't worry.
He'll trick on you.
You can sit on his face. He loves that shit.
Yeah.
Come on now. Matt's single. I'm gonna drop his IG somewhere here. Oh, hit him up, fam. Hit him up. Valentine's Day's over, so he's in it.
Okay.
He's like, fuck, I'm lost on that one.
I don't have anything else to say.
He's like, I don't know what to say now.
Do you guys have any other stuff you guys want to show our viewers?
Shit, you always got enough stuff.
Yeah.
You guys got enough stuff.
We're going to wrap it up right there.
Yeah, that's a fact, so.
All right, guys. Thank you guys for listening. I don't know if we said the number of this, but this is episode 89.
Subscribe. If you made it this far in the episode and you're not subscribed, shame on you. Subscribe.
Facts. Yeah, and
we're trying to get to 400, huh?
Yeah, we are just working. Again, thank you guys for just saying that you guys appreciate the episode drop so consistent.
Facts.
And we're just gonna keep putting our foot on their necks.
Yep.
And like that, it's been another episode of Roundtable Talk. But
you're. Let's get it, man. We out.
Foot.